Hello students, welcome to the new lecture. And in this lecture we are going to discuss few topics, and in the last lecture we have discussed about the evolution, and also we have taken the situations, three situations of the beetle population. In the each and every situation we have discussed some important aspect, okay? But in this topic or in this lecture we are going to discuss about main two things, that is Lamarckism and also Darwinism. So these are the two concepts. And again, in the Darwinism, we can see the theory of natural selection, survival of the fittest, Darwin's theory of evolution in a nutshell, identical thoughts of Charles Darwin and also Alfred Russel Wallace. So these are the concepts that we are going to cover in this topic. Okay. So first here is a Lamarck. Okay. The first is a Lamarck. So Lamarck is a scientist. Okay. His full name is Jean Baptiste Lamarck. This Jean Baptiste Lamarck proposed a theory. That theory is known as theory of evolution. Okay, so this theory of evolution says something important thing. What is meant by evolution? Let us consider this is an organism. So this organism is going to gain some kind of characteristics in this lifetime, and these characters accumulated and passed to the progeny. Okay, passed to the progeny. So this is known as evolution, such kind of transfer of all characters by the organism accumulated in the few generations ago, that is known as evolution. Okay, here this Jean Baptiste Lamarck proposed a theory of evolution for the first time. It means before the Lamarck, no one described about the evolution. Okay, so according to the Lamarck, some characters of the organism are developed during their lifetime, known as acquired characters. Okay, what is meant by acquired characters? What is, first of all, we have to understand the word acquired. Acquired is nothing but gaining. Okay, acquired is nothing but gaining. So when the organism is living, okay, this organism is going to gain some kind of characters. Okay, the characters are gained. Okay, so these characters are gained by the organism. So such kind of gaining of characters is known as acquired characters. So these characters may be anything. Okay, anything. For example, if you take the giraffe is elongated necks. Okay, elongated neck and four limbs. Okay, what is meant by four limbs? Okay, four limbs are nothing but front legs. Okay, hind limbs means back legs. Okay, or legs which are at back. Okay, so in the giraffe, the neck is elongated and also front legs also elongated. So this is one of the acquired characters in the giraffe. Okay, so Lamarck said at one point of time giraffes were equal to the size of the deer. Okay, but now if you compare giraffe and deer, now you will see a lot of difference. Deer is very small and giraffe is very, very tall, especially elongated necks and also elongated forelimbs. Okay, what is the main reason for such kind of huge drastic change or drastic change? There is only one thing. Some generations ago, or you can call it as a, so many generations ago, what happened? So this is the ground. Okay, on the ground the grass was completed, or the grass is very, very less. Okay, the giraffe had some problem because the shortage of food was there on the ground. So these giraffes, they tried to feed on the lower branches of the trees. Okay, it means they used to feed on this side. Okay, so what happened? So to feed on the lower branches of the trees, first of all they have to elongate the necks. It means some force has to be exerted on the neck and also on the legs, on the front legs. So as a result, such kind of continuous stretching for many generations. Okay, for many generations, the such kind of continuous stretching of their necks and also legs for many generations, such changes accumulated in the organisms. And at present you can see the giraffes with elongated necks and also elongated forelimbs. Okay, so this is about the Lamarckism. Okay, they have, as a result, now they have the long necks along with the elongated forelimbs. So these acquired characters like elongated necks, okay, necks and also elongated forelimbs, elongated forelimbs that is seen in the giraffe. Okay, so these are the acquired characters, and these acquired characters passed from the one generation to another generation and so on. So such kind of passing of these characters or traits from one generation to another generation and so on, that is known as inheritance of acquired characters. Why we are calling it is acquired inheritance of acquired characters? Inheritance means they are traveling, these characters are passed from the one generation to another generation and so on. So that is known as inheritance. We are calling it as acquired characters. Why? Because these characters are gained by the organism during their course of evolution. Okay, so this is known as theory of inheritance of acquired characters. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about another important person, that is known as August Weismann. Okay, here we can see August Weismann. This August Weismann tested inheritance of acquired characters, which is proposed by the Lamarck, Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. So what he did? So this August Weismann, he experimented on the rats. Okay, rats means a kind of mouse. So they experimented on the rats by removing the tails of parental rats for the 20 generations. It means this is the first generation of the rats. He took the rats, they are the parents. Okay, so he removed the tails. Okay, and the parents were crossed, and also the progeny is obtained, that is second generation. In the second generations also, he removed the tails. Okay, and they had reproduction. Okay, again produced third generation. So again a third generation also tails was removed by the scientist. So the fourth generation, the tails was removed again. Till how many generations? Till 20 generations. Till 20 generations, tail was removed every time. So if you see here, in each and every generation, the parents do not have any tail. The parents do not have any tail. Why? Because the scientist removed every time in each and every generation. But even after removing the tails, the individuals or the progeny had the perfect tail. Okay, without any loss of the tail or without any change in the shape of the tail. So what does it indicate? It indicates that based upon the experiment done by the August Weismann, it is proved that the bodily changes are not inherited. What is bodily changes? Here you can see bodily changes. What is bodily changes in these rats? The removal of tail. The removal of tail is the bodily changes. Okay, so here these bodily changes are not inherited. As a result, the progeny also having the tail without any loss of the tail. Okay, so hence these bodily changes cannot be passed to their progeny. If the bodily changes cannot be passed to the progeny, what will happen? The progeny will not have any defect. Okay, the progeny is perfect. Okay, this is about August Weismann theory or August Weismann experiment. So here there are two types of cells. Okay, we have to be, because of this August Weismann experiment, we have to discuss about the important aspects. So there are two types of cells. One is somatic. Okay, so the somatic, and next is germ cells. The somatics and somatic cells and also germ cells. So somatic cells is for the normal body. Okay, normal body cells. What is germ cells? Germ cells are nothing but they are used for the gamete formation. Okay, formation of gametes. For example, if there is any change in the somatic cells, so no transmission. Okay, no appearance in the progeny. Okay, no appearance in the progeny. Okay, if there is any change in the gametes, okay, if there is any change in the DNA of the gametes, so what will happen exactly? So those characters or change will be seen in the progeny. Okay, so in the progeny is observed. So here no such kind of changes is available if there is any change in the somatic cells. But if there is any change in germ cells, there is such kind of change is shown in the progeny of the individuals. Okay, so here what the experiment is about, the August Weismann, he said that somatic cells do not show any impact on the change of the DNA in the progeny. Okay, so this is about experiment done by the August Weismann. Okay, so next one will be the Darwinism. So Charles Darwin belongs to the age, okay, 1809 to 1882. So he was born in the England, and at the age of 22 he voyage is nothing but a travel. Okay, he traveled in the HMS Beagle ship. So it is a ship. So it is a huge ship. It went to the world survey for the 5 years. So in this ship Charles Darwin traveled. So why he traveled? He traveled for the observing the nature and also to learn from the nature. Okay, so what he observed in the islands of the Galapagos. Island is nothing but a place, okay, which is completely surrounded with water on all sides. Okay, so on islands of the Galapagos, so he observed the flora and fauna. The flora is nothing but the plants, fauna is nothing but animals. Fauna means animals. He observed different types of animals and different types of the plants. So he gathered lot of information and evidence. Lot of information and evidence is gathered from these Galapagos islands. So based upon the evidences and information collected from these Galapagos islands, he proposed a theory. Proposition nothing but saying. Okay, proposition means the saying. He said that theory of evolution. He said about the theory of natural selection and also theory of evolution. These are the two theories proposed by the Charles Darwin based upon his observation and evidences and information collected from the Galapagos island. So he observed the diversity of the finches. Okay, what is meant by finch birds? Finch bird is nothing but a type of birds. So in this class, in this lesson only, in this chapter only, we will discuss about the Darwin finches is nothing but birds, okay, which is observed by the Charles Darwin in the Galapagos Islands. So he observed carefully on the finch birds of the Galapagos Islands. They exhibit different diversity in structure. So finch, nothing but a bird. So these have the some certain kind of beaks. Okay, these birds have the beaks. So he observed many birds. The beaks of the birds are different shapes. Some are long, some are like needles, some are strong. Some are very, very tiny, some are very, very strong to crack the seed, and so on. So if you see the different diversities there, diversity is nothing but different ways, okay, different structures. So such kind of diversity in the structure of these Darwin finches or the finch birds is seen by the Darwin, okay. So this is about observations and also voyage of the Darwin in this few points. So next few points we are going to discuss about the books that is influenced by the Charles Darwin, and also about his theory writing and also book publication. So what the points are about. Charles Darwin was influenced by the two books. Okay, influenced by the two books. Those books are The Principles of Geology by Charles Lyell. First one is The Principles of Geology by Charles Lyell, and second one is The Malthus Theory by the Malthus. These are the two books. With the help of these two books, Charles Darwin influenced a lot. So among these two books, the first one is The Principles of Geology by Charles Lyell. He did not accepted it. Okay, Charles Lyell, whatever he wrote, so the Darwin did not accepted or agreed with this book. Okay, so why? Because this book is saying that this book or Charles Lyell is saying that geological changes occurred in the uniform rate, but okay, Darwin did not accept to this, and he felt that large changes are occurred due to the accumulation of small changes. Okay, next he moved to the next book. That book is Malthus. Okay, according to the Malthus, Malthus said the population grows in geometrical progressions like 1, 2, 4, 8 and so on. This is the geometrical progressions, and also where the food source is increasing in the arithmetic progression. So arithmetic progressions like 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this is about the Malthus theory. Now the Charles Darwin accepted this. Okay, Charles Darwin accepted this, and based on this Darwin proposed a theory of natural selection. So based upon the book proposed by the Malthus, okay, that book is known as Malthus theory. Based upon the Malthus theory, Charles Darwin proposed natural selection. The Charles Darwin did not agree with the Charles Lyell book. Okay, so the Charles Lyell book was, he wrote the Principles of Geology. Okay, next one will be the theory of natural selection. So theory of natural selection, the word itself says about nature. Okay, the natural selection is saying that the statement itself is saying that there is a theory, okay, and there is a natural selection. What is natural selection? The nature is going to select something. So nature is going to select something that is known as natural selection. We will see what nature is selecting, how the nature is selecting in this topic. Okay, here the nature only select or decide which organism should survive and which organism should perish in nature. It means nature is going to decide which organism has to survive and which organism has to die. Okay, such kind of process is known as survival of the fittest. What is meant by survival? Survival means living condition. So it means nature is going to select which organism should live and which organism should die. Okay, such kind of aspect is known as a survival of the fittest, or the theory is known as theory of natural selection. So based on what the nature is going to select, the nature is going to select on the only two things, the useful variations and also non-useful variations. So the traits are characters. There are two types. One is the useful, another is a non-useful. So this is useful trait, this is useful, and this is non-useful. Okay, so these useful traits, all these traits are coming from, the characters or traits are coming from what? To the evolution. So if the traits are useful to the organism, the useful traits are going to help the organism to survive. Okay, so as a result, nature is going to select and nature makes the organism to survive. Okay, and here the traits are not useful, it means these traits are not going to help the organism. As a result, nature is not going to help the organism to survive. It means these organisms are killed in the future. Okay, these organisms will not be killed and these organisms are going to survive in the future. So this is known as such kind of selection, and also such kind of deselection by the nature is known as theory of natural selection. Okay, hence you can see if the traits are not useful to the organism, then they are going to be eliminated from the environment. This is nothing but perish. And next is organisms with useful traits will survive. Okay, organism with useful traits will survive. So what is meant by useful traits? For example, if a deer is there, okay, if the deer is good at running, so that is a useful trait. Okay, why? Because it can escape from the tigers. Okay, as a result, the deer is going to survive. For example, in some other forest, the deer cannot run faster. Okay, deer will run very, very slowly. So such kind of slow running of the deer is not useful variation. In that case, this deer in this forest is going to die, okay, in the future. Why? Because the nature will not accept such kind of deers to live in the nature. Okay, that is, these deers are going to perish. Okay, these deers are going to get perished, and these deers are going to survive in the future. Okay, so this is known as theory of natural selection. Nature will select which organism has to die and which organism has to live in the future. Okay, next is the survival of the fittest. Okay, survival of the fittest is almost equal to the survival is equal to the previous topic that we have discussed, that is nothing but theory of natural selection. So among the individuals of the population, so the organisms with the useful variations are retained. Okay, so useful variations are retained. What is meant by useful variations? Here you can see, So the variations, okay, the variations, again there are two types, okay. Useful variations and also non-useful, okay. Useful variations and also non-useful variations. If the variations are useful to the organism, these useful variations are going to get retained, okay. Retained means what? These variations will be in the body of the organisms, okay. In the body of the organism, that is known as retaining, okay. And non-useful variations are lost, okay. It means non-useful vari organisms with the non-useful variations are lost. Means these organisms which have the normal va non-useful variation, they are going to loss, okay, or they are lost, okay. These mean these organisms are going to die, okay. Only the fittest. It means they are here. You can see the non-useful variations are lost if there is struggle in the population for the existence of only fittest will survive. So here you can see the organisms with the useful variations and organisms with non-useful variations, okay. So if there is competition, okay, if there is competition, okay, which one will survive? Definitely the organisms with the useful variations is going to survive. So the competition for what? The competition is for different aspects like food, okay, space, mating, etc. These all are the aspect for the competition. So in that conditions, which one will survive? The organisms with useful organisms with useful variations, okay, is going to survive, okay. So this is nothing but the survival of the fittest. Survival of the fittest means the whatever the organism is fit to survive, those organisms is going to live. That is known as the survival of the fittest, okay. So each species tend to produce large number of offsprings. What is meant by offsprings? Okay, offsprings are nothing but the progeny. So the offsprings are nothing but the progeny. Here the many number, so many progeny are produced by the organism. Why? Because why the so many number of organisms progeny is produced by the organism? So why? Because to compete, okay, these organisms are nothing but the progeny. These progeny has to compete in the nature, okay, compete in the nature. And these progeny are, if the progeny are more, there is definitely the competition. So competition for what? Competition for the food, okay, competition for the food, space, etc. If you see the human population also, the population of human beings is very very high, okay. It means due to the overpopulation of the human beings, now human beings, between human beings there is a competition. So competition for the food, competition for the space, competition for the jobs, etc. So the competition in the human beings is increased. Competition between human beings is increased. Why? Because the human beings population is more. Okay. In the same way, if the population of the progeny is more, in that case, the competition will be more in the progeny. Okay. Hence, there is struggling for the existence. So to survive in the nature, what will be there? There is struggle. Struggle or fighting will be there. So struggle there for the existence. Only the organism with useful variations, they are going to survive. Okay, here you can see the organism with useful variations is going to survive, and organism without useful variations will not survive. It means that nature is going to help the organisms only with the useful variations, and nature will not help the non-useful, or nature will not help the organisms with the non-useful variations. Okay, so this is about survival of the fittest. Okay. Next one will be the Darwin's theory of evolution in nutshell. What is meant by nutshell? Nutshell is nothing but in a short, okay, in a short sentence or in a short way. That is known as nutshell. Here we are going to discuss Darwin's theory of evolution in a short form, okay. So what is that short form? There are few points to describe about Darwin's theory of evolution in a short way. So the first, any group of population of an organism develops variations and all members of the groups are not identical. So in each and every member of the organism of the group is going to have some kind of variations. It means each and every organism. So each and every organism is going to have some kind of variations. Okay. Variations, and these variations in the organisms are not similar, or you can call it as not identical. Okay. Not identical means not same. Okay. So these variants are passed from the parents to progeny through heredity. So what is the difference between inheritance and heredity? Heredity is nothing but parents to children. Okay, parents to children, or you can call it as a parent to the progeny. That is known as heredity. Okay, what is meant by inheritance? Okay, the generation. Okay, from one generation to the next generation. Okay, and so on. Such kind of carrying of information from one generation to next generation, and so on. Such kind of passing of information from one to another generations. That is known as inheritance. Okay, inheritance. Remember, carefully remember these words like inheritance and also heredity. It may be asked in the exams. Okay, so over abundance of offsprings lead to the constant struggle. Abundance means what? Abundance means more number of individuals. If the individuals are very more, okay, if the individuals are more, that is more progeny, in that case the increased progeny or increased population is going to create struggle. Okay, create struggle among the individuals. Okay, so among the individuals, so this is known as constant struggle. Constant means this struggle or this fighting will be there all the time. So why this fighting is there? This is only for the survival, only for survival, and also for the few aspect like food, space, and also mating with other individuals. That is only the reason why there is abundance of offsprings for the constant struggle. Okay, in the human population also you will see there is always a struggle for the job, always a struggle for the purchasing land. It means the price of the land is increasing day by day. Why? Because the population is increasing, so the prices are increasing. Only the people who have the more money and capacity to survive, capacity to earn more money and power, they are only going to survive better in the nature. Okay, so here the more useful variations of individuals help in the survival, okay, reproduction, and also living longer. Okay, these organisms are also going to survive. Okay, these are nothing but useful variations. Useful variation means these variations that help the organism to survive and longer, and also more offsprings. So these organisms only, they are going to produce more amount of offsprings than the organisms with less useful variations. The organisms with less useful variation, they are not going to survive longer, they are not going to reproduce, and they are not going to reproduce many progeny, and they are also not going to live for longer time. Why? Because the variations in these organisms are not going to help them to survive. It means nature is not going to help these organisms, the organisms which have the less useful variations. Okay, next is the offsprings of survivors inherit the useful variations. So for example, this organism is there, this organism has some kind of useful variations. These useful variations will be passed to the progeny. Okay, let us consider how many progeny. There are 100 progeny. So due to some accidents or due to some competitions, due to the increased competition in the progeny, let us consider only how many survived. Only 10 progeny survived. Okay, only 10 progeny survived. So this 10 progeny is going to transmit these useful variations. Okay, here also they have the useful variation received from the parents, and also here also they have the useful variations. So these 10 progeny which have survived, they are going to promote these such kind of useful variations to the next progeny. Okay, so again, 10 progeny, let us consider the 10 progeny is reproduced, and also they have produced 20 progeny. Okay, this 20 progeny will have the useful variation that have been brought from their ancestors. Okay, it means the progeny which have survived, they are going to carry on the useful variations to the next generations. Only the progeny which have survived only. Okay, so this is about the survivor and also inheritance of the useful variation. This is known as inheritance. Okay, so inheritance. Why? Because there are many progeny, there are many generations, first generation, second generation, and this is the third generation. It means transferring of such kind of information or useful traits from one generation to another generation and so on. Such kind of a procedure is known as inheritance. Okay. So, and also becomes till how many generations it is going to continue. This is going to continue till these useful variations turns into common feature. Okay, common feature. So till the useful variations becomes a common feature, such kind of transmission of useful variations will occur. So if once it becomes a common feature, it is over. Okay, again it is going to again some kind of other useful variations or useful traits. Okay, so as the environment changes, the organisms within the environment accept or adapt to the changes to the new living conditions. For example, here you can see the organisms. If you place the organism in the cold regions, so previously it was in the hot regions. Now if you place this organism in the cold regions, what will happen? This organism is going to develop or it is going to adapt. Okay, it is going to adapt to the new environment. Such kind of adaptation is seen. So they are going to adapt to the environment and also the living conditions. So such kind of procedure is known as adaptation. Okay, so such kind of procedure is known as adaptation. What is meant by adaptation? Adaptation is nothing but, so these organisms, adaptation is nothing but adapting or habituating to the new environmental conditions, that is known as adapt or adapting to the changes. Okay, here the what is different condition like hot, now it is a different conditions like cold. You put the organisms from the hot condition to the cold conditions, so the temperature, the environment is separate. Okay, so the new environment, this organism is going to adjust to the new environmental conditions. Such kind of adaptation or changing to the environment, that is known as adaptation. Okay, so here the over long period of time, the species, each species is going to accumulate so many changes. So such kind of so many changes is known leading to the formation of the new species. Let us consider this is an organism, and this organism has a changes. So one generation, second generation, third generation, and so on. So in every generation there is some kind of changes. Okay, some kind of accumulation of many changes or so many changes. So here will be the changes, here will be the change, here will be the change, and so on. Such kind of accumulation of changes over few generations or many generations, this is going to form a new species. This is going to form a new species. How the new species is formed? New species is formed due to the accumulation of the changes or due to accumulation of the characters for so many generations. Or many changes, that is leading to the formation of the new species. But distinctly different from the original species. So this new species, if you compare the new species and also original organisms or original species, they are similar. Okay, both are similar. Okay, but they are distinctly different. Okay, they are distinctly different from the original species. So all species on the earth arise in this way. Okay, all new species are going to arise in this way. Okay, so next is identical thoughts of Charles Darwin and also Alfred Russel Wallace. Okay, so the first, Charles Darwin. Okay, so Charles Darwin. And also Alfred Russel Wallace. We will call him as a Russel Wallace. Okay. Okay. So these are the two persons, Charles Darwin and also Alfred Russel Wallace. So he was formulating the theory of origin of new species. Okay. So he was formulating in the mind. Okay. Charles Darwin and Russel Wallace. He made the origin of new species. Origin of new species and sent letter, okay, and sent a letter to the Charles Darwin. So the Charles Darwin received the letter from the Alfred Russel Wallace. Okay, Alfred Russel Wallace. And after opening the letter from the Alfred Russel Wallace by the Charles Darwin, the Charles Darwin was surprised. What is there in the letter? It is stated that देर इज समथिंग इंफॉर्मेशन रोट अबाउट द ऑरिजिन ऑफ न्यू स्पीशीज बाय द रूसेल वैलिस. सो द सेम थियरी वॉज फॉर्मुलेटिंग बाय द चार्ल्स डार्विन इन हिस माइंड. सो व्हाट चार्ल्स डार्विन वॉज डूइंग, सो ही वॉज फॉर्मुलेटिंग अबाउट द ऑरिजिन ऑफ न्यू स्पीशीज थियरी इन हिस माइंड. बट वॉट एवर थियरी इज देर इन हिस माइंड इज देर इन द लेटर. ओके, सो दिस इज द रीजन चार्ल्स डार्विन वॉज सरप्राइज्ड बाई ओपनिंग द लेटर. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट, सो चार्ल्स डार्विन एंड ऑल्सो अल्फ्रेड रूसेल वैलिस टूगेदर दे पब्लिश्ड एन आर्टिकल इन द जर्नल. वॉट इज बाय आर्टिकल? आर्टिकल इज नथिंग बट सम काइंड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, सम काइंड ऑफ रिटन इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट समथिंग. ओके, सो इट इज लाइक अ थियरी. ओके, सो दे द चार्ल्स डार्विन एंड ऑल्सो अल्फ्रेड रूसेल वैलिस दे पब्लिश्ड ए आर्टिकल इन द जर्नल. जर्नल इज नथिंग बट इट्स काइंड ऑफ a media that is going to say your experiment or your observations to everyone. Okay, that is known as journal. So in which journal? Journal of Linnean Society. Journal of Linnean Society is a type of journal. So in this journal they have published together Charles Darwin and also Alfred Russel Wallace. They jointly published about the natural selection. Okay, about the natural selection. Okay, so this in the year 1859, okay, Charles Darwin published the book Origin of New Species. Okay, so in the year 1859 Charles Darwin published the book name is Origin of Species. Okay, so their thoughts gained criticism because they could not explain about how the variations are inherited after the discovery and proper understanding of the mitosis and meiosis. So Charles Darwin and also Alfred Russel Wallace, okay, so they have proposed something. It means they have said something to the world. Okay, so whatever they have said, okay, they gained criticism. Why? Because they couldn't explain how the variations are inherited. So when the proper discovery and also understanding of the mitosis and meiosis were seen. Okay, so why? Because mitosis, meiosis, it is a complex procedure. So they could not understand about the mitosis, meiosis, and how the genes are transferring from the parents to progeny, the DNA, how it is passing from one generation to another, next generation, and so on. So this is the reason they could not explain how the variations are inherited from the parent to the progeny. Okay, this is the gaining of the criticism. Okay, so this is about the lecture, and if you have any doubts or questions and suggestions, feel free to post in the comment section so that I can answer to your questions or doubts and so on. Okay, so this is about today's lecture, and in the next lecture we are going to discuss about the next topic. Okay.